So next we have a first chef of the night, Chef Pascal Olhats. Come on up, a French chef. I'm excited. French born, trained executive chef. So chef, if you were a food, what would you be and why?
Oh, I could be many things, because you know, my life is about food. But you know, I like butter.
Why would you be butter?
I like butter. Because you have a little bit of butter, but then you always have a smile when you spread it on your bread. You know, that's a good sign, to be able to spread butter on your piece of bread and then have a bite.
And always smile.
And when you cook, butter makes food, the sauce shine. So this is why we add butter to the sauce, not to make it better or richer. Do it at home. Next time, you have a little sauce, add a little piece of butter, you mix it, and then you start to shine.
And you're shining tonight. Thank you so much. And your story, I know we have titles of your story. Your story is putting the duck in a turkey.
Thank you.
Well, you're welcome. Well, yeah, I was a little torn about the title. It could be the turkey against the duck, oh, you'll see why. Of course, when you ask me about a food story, being a chef, I may have been born as a chef, but so I have many stories, and it's very hard to just put one just like this. But because we are connected tonight with our food and community, of course, Thanksgiving is the first thing that comes to my mind. So, and being French, you know, we love food. We love having friends at home. We love to have everybody, breakfast, lunch, and dinner. When you wake up, you think what you're going to have for lunch. And at lunch, you talk what you're going to have for dinner. It's good to be lucky to think that way, but this is what the way we drive in France, the way we think, Sparta, of our. It's a family sport. I mean, lunch, dinner. So, we have a good team around the table. So, when I was a kid, you know, my dad and my mother were all rivalry in the kitchen because my dad was more. I was born in Normandy, and it's like Normandy is a Wisconsin, butter, cream, cheese, you know, and the fields are always green. So we spend more time at the table because usually it's cold and rainy outside. So why going out when we have a lot of things around us on the table in front of us? So one day we were driving and my dad, you know, he was an amazing man because it was a little bit after World War II. I have to say my dad was a very strong man, just to give him some credit. He was prisoner twice and escaped twice from Germany. And when he came back, he engaged himself in to fight back, you know, on the local. And so he really, really was a fighter, never give up. So nothing stopped him. So he was also a truck driver. So we were in his car and they said, oh, let's stop. And then suddenly he take a hammer and he take a rope and put the rope around the hammer and say, Dad, what are you going to do? Well, we need some fresh chestnut for home. So he take the rope and the hammer and then threw it in the trees and then bam, chestnut fell down. Okay. Wow, that's good. But you have to be careful, you don't want to have the hammer on your head. No? That, you know, could be dangerous. I probably was 14 years old. And so no hammer head, nothing, so keep on looking. And then I picked the chestnut, you know, and suddenly a chestnut came down and boom, in my eye. Oh, so there was a little scary. And so, oh, don't worry, just wipe it and we go. But I go home, a little pain, feeling that. But, you know, my mother was really upset because she said, what did you do if Pascal got a hammer on his head? And, no, don't worry, that's fine. He said, so good, so fine. And then she got upset again because my dad, we had to roast the chestnut, you know, you have to peel him because you know, we have all these stones around it. And then take my mom's very favorite pan, he poke holes into the pan so we can roast the chestnut, you know. smell really good at all, no? But the pan is just a pan that you can use only for chestnut a few times a year. There was a lot of upset. Another thing that made my mother upset is the next day I went to school, and when she picked me up, my eyes were so swollen, was so red. Oh. I said, what's going on? And she took me to the hospital. Right away, and the doctor said, I'm glad you came, because if you didn't come today, you know, I could have lost my eye. So they opened up and they removed all the whole spike and all the whole tumors. And now I can see you. I'm okay. I had lost a few points and one eye, but it's okay. Now I still have two eyes. That's good. So, we do chestnut in France during the holidays because we do turkey, roasted turkey, roasted chestnut. This is the traditional holiday Christmas way to celebrate roasted turkey. But the French, I cannot be fed up on turkeys. No? Turkeys is an interesting bird, it's an interesting food. It's not the easiest one to cook, it's not the best result all the time. No, it's very hard to always make the perfect turkey. And you know that. I'm very surprised that it is the number one traditional food for Thanksgiving. And everybody in the US tried to make the best turkey. So it's not that competition, I guess. There's something there. But you grind it, you roast it, you pickle it, you fry it. Every way you do it, try to be better every year. And I know there's eight on this, but. So when I move back here to see the connection from the fresh turkey that we move away from turkey in France, I was not going to cook any turkeys anymore. And this is not what I like to do. One of my first Thanksgiving, I wanted to show that I'm a good French chef. I invite my friends. And because I was new in the country, I felt like I was a pilgrim, I was French, I was by myself. I said, I need to give back. This is what I didn't mind. So I invited all my friends at home. But no turkey. We had roasted duck, we had foie gras, we had some roast beef, but no turkey. Everybody had a great meal, and fantastic. But the following days, people can say, yeah, it was great, but it was not a Thanksgiving dinner. Sorry. No. What's a Thanksgiving dinner? It's plainly the turkey, or the side, the stuffing, or the trimming. But maybe one day I will try. And yes, now, when I cook, I'm cooking the real Thanksgiving dinner. Why? Because I believe that Thanksgiving is such a beautiful thing that we have in the US. It is the day when everybody gets together. This is really the day that reminds me what we do in France, food culture, family together, around the table, and everybody contribute or cook for each other. It's wonderful. So now I believe in Thanksgiving. And now I believe in turkeys and stuffing, on gravy, on mashed potato, on pies. What was it in pie? So that was your pie.
Me.
Yes. So now that I believe in it, you know what happened? Thanksgiving, I'm cooking about 40 turkeys. I'm talking about 400 pounds of stuffing. 30 gallons of gravy and pies and pies and pies. I still don't like much turkeys. The only place I like is, when you roast a turkey, the bottom part is dead moist. They are the oysters.
Yeah.
Yes.
So if you buy a turkey or other turkey from, maybe you will miss one oyster. No, because this is the thing I will always treat myself on. But I really believe that Thanksgiving is an amazing thing. I did several times. I saw in the Mission, I did one on serve people there at Thanksgiving time. It's so beautiful to do that, you know, and everybody should go through this type of situation. And so, to say, I love Thanksgiving because what brings people to it. And I do believe we should have more than one Thanksgiving a year. I think we need to have at least once a month, we should have find something. It doesn't have to be turkey, no? I can say, you know, it could be the duck of the month, no, it could be the horse, but a good meal, get together, you know, and Thanksgiving will keep on going forever. Thank you.